In this video, you get 2 free end cards to enhance your videos or projects. Hello and welcome guys, ArmaganVideos here. In this video, you're going to get 2 free end cards to enhance your videos or projects, and they are designed in a way that you can combine them with my first templates that I've created just 1 or 2 weeks ago. You can find the video in the top right corner right now. And yeah, 1 or 2 weeks ago, I've created intros or title sequences that you can use for the beginning of your videos. And these templates that you can get here in this video are end cards, which you can put at the end of your videos so that they link to 2 other videos and to the subscribe button for your channel. And these are called end cards. They are very easy to customize. Yeah, all you need to do is download them from the description below and put them into Premiere Pro. I'm going to show you how to use and customize them after this intro. This is a very short video, but one important note, you really need to have the latest version of Premiere Pro and After Effects CC 2017, because in April there was an update with some major features. For example, the motion graphics templates, which we are using with these templates. Yeah, you need to make sure that you have After Effects and Premiere Pro to be able to use these templates. I hope you're really going to enjoy this, and if you're using the templates, make sure to give me a little credit and maybe share your outcome on Instagram or anywhere with the hashtag ArmaganVideos. I'm going to check them out and comment on them and maybe give you tips on what you can do better. And yeah, without further ado, let's jump straight to Premiere Pro and use these templates. All right, so let's open up Premiere Pro, create a new project, and then go to Window, Essential Graphics, so you can see the panel on the right. Then go to File, New Sequence, and I'm using AVCHD 1080p 30fps and type in a sequence name. Now drag in your footage into the project and drag that footage into the sequence. And we're going to use Keep Existing Settings because we don't want to change them. Alright, so far so good. Now click this little icon to install the motion graphics templates that I'm providing in the description below. Just hit open, you can see them right in the essential graphics panel. And yeah, now let's drag in the templates just like this. Let's trim our footage right there so we can actually see what we're doing right here. And now you can see that we got our template loaded in and it's super nice, loading very fast. You don't even have to pre-render it because these are very basic animations in After Effects, but crazy to do in Premiere. That's why I'm sharing these templates with you. And when you're clicking on the template, you can see that you get several options. For the top text, you can slide it up and down via the X and Y sliders. You can change the main color, which is pink right here. And you can also change all the text. And there's also an eyedropper for the color right there, but I'm just going to leave it on pink because the contrast is nice right now. You can also change the amount of noise on the text itself, and you also have options for the glow threshold, the glow radius, and the glow intensity on the main colored text right there, the pinkish ones, just like that. And yeah, I'm just going to bring down the intensity a little bit because it was too strong. If you now click on the lifestyle template or the vlogger template, you can see that you can change or manipulate the text as well. And you got the same options right here. You can move them in X and Y, each of the texts, and yeah. The only difference to the other template right here is you don't have the glow settings, but therefore you got the hide scribble effect button right there. And you also got the amount of noise on text, and the hide scribble effect button is very self-explanatory. There's a little scribble effect and you can turn it off and on depending on your needs or however you will like them. And if you now render this out and you've put your outro or end card at the end of your video, you can now upload it to YouTube and then go to the end screen and annotation screen and make sure to select the preset or the template from YouTube itself. And as you can tell, you don't have to move anything. It's perfectly aligned with my template already. And if you now play this, you will be able to see that your linked videos and the subscribe button in the middle will be perfectly fitting into the pre-made boxes and circle that I've created in the template. And well, all you need to do now is download these templates, leave a comment, like and subscribe, and also enable the bell under this video so you get notified whenever I upload a new video. Shoot me a message on Facebook for new tutorial ideas. Until the next time, ArmaganVideos.